Hey guys, today I'm coming to you from the Museum of Transportation here in St. Louis, Missouri. And I have a really unique vehicle to show you today. This is a 1963 Chrysler Turbine. And this is an exceedingly rare car. In fact, there are only three running examples left in the world. One owned by Jay Leno, the second owned by Chrysler themselves, and then the third one that you see right before you here. And we have a unique opportunity to take a close look at it, so we're going to do just that. You can see the styling is pretty unique for the time. They were definitely going for kind of a futuristic appearance. And this car was actually styled by Ghia in Turin, Italy, and then they brought the bodies back to America where the final assembly was completed. And definitely a very unique car. The most interesting feature of the car, obviously, is the power plant, which is a gas turbine. And this particular car is actually set up to burn kerosene at the present time. But it actually could be considered an alternative fuel vehicle, because it will actually burn most combustible fuels, any of them that will actually mix with oxygen and combust. But it's a unique power plant for sure. This is similar to what you would find in, you know, a helicopter, a plane. Even some ships are powered by turbines now, but pretty interesting. Here, we'll kind of take a look around the engine here. But, this particular power plant puts out 130 horsepower and 425 pound-feet of torque, and it actually idles at around 22,000 RPM. So it's definitely a lot different than your typical combustion engine. And the way this works, you can see up front here, it's got a couple of air intakes right up in the front grill, and it draws air into the combustion chamber. And there's actually, the air is compressed, and then it reaches a temperature of 425 degrees Fahrenheit before it's ignited or anything. And then fuel is actually injected into the combustion chamber with the air, and then it's ignited by a single spark plug. And then obviously that's a lot of heat being produced, and a lot of that would normally just go out the exhaust and be wasted. But they've actually developed a system on here that actually reclaims some of that heat and puts it to good use. And what they've done is it actually has a pair of heat exchangers that takes the heat from the exhaust and uses it to actually heat up the incoming air charge. So now with the heat exchangers and the combustion, you can actually see temperatures in here of up to 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. So obviously much different than your typical car engine. And so definitely an interesting power plant. And it was kind of a technological showcase for Chrysler at the time. Now all the power from this turbine is actually funneled back through a 727 torque flight automatic, which is your typical three-speed automatic transmission. And so it gives you a driving experience that's pretty similar to an ordinary car at the time. Obviously there's a few differences. We'll take a look at the interior here, and you can see it's got some futuristic elements as well. At the center hump there, you can see at the back of the tunnel they actually have some little blades that kind of recall the turbine. And then up here you'll see some of your switches, like for your blower motor, the rear defroster, interior lamps, all there in the center console. And then the selector here with the black knob, that's actually your gear selector for the transmission. So you can pick to either put it in drive or reverse. And you'll notice it has the big wheel with the horn hoop and a nice set of gauges as well. It's actually got three separate gauge pods. And so you got all the instruments that you would need. Very nice. And you'll notice it's got a black vinyl top on it, which is pretty common for the time. And this color is actually called Turbine Bronze. And at the time, Chrysler built 55 of these cars in total, 54 in this Turbine Bronze color. And they had a program where they allowed people to test out this car, and actually 203 people in total were allowed to drive this car over a few month period, and then the cars were returned to Chrysler. Now, when this program was over, they actually offered these cars, a number of them, to museums for display. And believe it or not, a lot of the museums actually turned them down. I don't know if it had to do with maintenance costs or what the actual issue was at the time, but it's actually hard to believe now that they turned down these cars. So actually, Chrysler ended up reclaiming them and actually destroying them. And they actually destroyed, out of 55, there were only 7 remaining at that time. And then over the years, it's actually dwindled down to the point where, like I said, there are only 3 in operation today. So definitely one of the most rare cars on the planet, and very unique, obviously, with that power plant in there. I just thought we were really fortunate today to be able to take such a nice close look at it, because it's definitely something you don't get an opportunity to check out very often. But anyway, guys, hopefully you found that interesting. And like I said, this is located at the Museum of Transportation here in St. Louis, Missouri. So if you're in the area and you have the chance, bring your family by and check it out for yourself. Anyway, thanks for watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.